point on, we decided as a command staff that it was very important from this point going forward that we do a better job of making sure that our staff, the police officers, the community, and everybody really understood and knew about the sacrifices that people made before us and knew about the contributions that people made before we were here in this community serving. So we decided, you know, what better way than to go back, look at some things, and create a Hall of Fame and honor some of the individuals who served this community before we were here. I would first like to call up the family of Major Spencer Gary. And you know, you already see Major Gary's picture up there. He is the cornerstone of this Hall of Fame. We don't need to put a picture up there for him. It's already there. Like I said, he's the cornerstone, and we're going to build this Hall of Fame around him. Major Gary was hired by the Georgetown Police Department on March 1st, 1979 as a patrol officer. He rose through the ranks of the department and was appointed Deputy Chief of Police in February of 1990. On March 7th of 1994, Major Gary made the ultimate sacrifice while investigating a suspicious vehicle. Major Gary died 2 days later from his injuries. We will never forget the sacrifice that Major Gary made for this community, and I am honored and humbled today to be able to induct Major Spencer Gary into the Georgetown Police Department's Hall of Fame. We have a small token for the family that we just want you to take with you. I let you know we appreciate you being here today, and we honor Major Gary.
I just want to thank you guys for 23 years now. You guys have made us feel part of the family. I mean, there was a huge void left with the passing of our father, and you guys helped us, whether it was taking us to school, picking us up from school, teaching us to drive, teaching us how to shave, pretty much anything. Police department's always been there. We
first
greatly appreciate that.
Yeah.
A lot of things. We greatly appreciate it. Thank you.
Next, I would like to call up the family of Thomas Devon Tindall. Thomas Devon Tindall. Mr. Tindall was hired by the Georgetown Police Department on September 3rd, 1964. Officer Tindall was critically injured in an automobile accident while on duty as a patrolman on December 25th, 1965. As a result of the accident, he was left a quadriplegic. He died 15 years later on December 25th, 1980. As a result of injuries that he sustained from the accident. I'm proud and I'm honored today to be able to induct Thomas Devon Tindall into the Georgetown Police Department Hall of Fame. I would now like to call up the family of Courtney Bain Dorsey. Courtney was a member of the Georgetown Police Department's Camp GPD Blue. On July 3rd, 2016, he lost his life while attempting to save his brother from drowning in the ocean at Palmer's Island. Courtney was posthumously awarded the title of Honorary Reserve Police Officer. And as I said, Courtney will always be a part of his family. We will always remember him, and I'm proud and honored to be able to induct him into the Georgetown Police Department's Hall of Fame. I would now like to call up the family of Councilman Clarence Smalls. Mr. Smalls was hired by the Georgetown Police Department on January 16, 1967. He rose through the ranks of the department to the rank of sergeant. He retired after 27 years of service. Mr. Smalls was elected to Georgetown City Council in 1996. Councilman Smalls was instrumental in obtaining the support and funds needed to build the new Georgetown Police Department. Clarence Smalls. I'm humbled and I'm honored to induct you to the Georgetown Police Department. Last but not least, I'd like to call up former Chief Dan Furr and his lovely wife. Mr. Furr was hired by the Georgetown Police Department on December 11, 1985. He rose through the ranks of the department and was appointed Chief of Police in February of 1996. Chief Furr was instrumental in the design and construction of the new Georgetown Police Department. Chief Furr retired in May of 2007 when he was appointed by the governor as a magistrate for Georgetown. Dan Furr. I'm proud and humbled to induct you into the Georgetown Police Department's Hall of Fame.
I, as the chief said, I left the police department in May the 2nd, 2007, after 22 years. But I tell you, the department never left me. It's constantly in my heart. And I miss everybody. It's great seeing the guys that I served with here. A lot of them are still here. And it was my pleasure to serve the city of Georgetown. Kathy, anything?
No, we had a good run here. I didn't involve myself in the police department. We agreed early on when Dan was a young police officer that it was a don't ask, don't tell. I didn't ask him when he came home and he didn't tell me. It worked well for us.
Thank you, Chief. Thank you.
With his blood.